as Real Estate three weeks away from Survivor Series as we come to you live in B-Town, known as Boston, Massachusetts, in front of 15,000 fans. Welcome to SmackDown Live. As we begin the show with the hometown superstar here in the TD Garden, John Cena. Last week, John Cena had a huge main event, a rematch from the draft night back in April after WrestleMania against Sami Zayn, and Zayn was able to get revenge on John Cena, able to get redemption, and defeated John Cena in a shocking fashion by making John Cena submit to the Koji Clutch, I should say. It's John Cena in his hometown. Looking forward to face Seth Rollins at Survivor Series for the WWE title. The number one contender will be in action to begin SmackDown Live. John Cena in front of his friends and families and all of his fans will be in action against the Intercontinental Champion, The Miz. John Cena has the opportunity to win the WWE Championship for the second time this year alone at Survivor Series. The first time he won the championship was back at the Royal Rumble when he defeated Stone Cold Steve Austin. And he was able to hold on to the title until after WrestleMania. Here comes the Intercontinental Champion, able to pull off a massive win, a massive upset at Unforgiven. The Miz, the Intercontinental Champion, able to win the title in a fatal four-way, first ever fatal four-way Hell in a Cell match against AJ Styles, Kevin Owens, and Hideo Itami for the Intercontinental title. And now The Miz will be defending the championship at Survivor Series against Ty Dillinger. Dillinger able to get a win over The Miz a couple weeks back on SmackDown Live. And now The Miz looking to take on John Cena to begin SmackDown. And Ty Dillinger will be in action later on tonight as he will be taking on the WWE Champion Seth Rollins. That'll be our main event later on tonight here in Boston. So the last time between Ty Dillinger and Seth Rollins went at it a couple of months back on SmackDown, but Ty Dillinger had the chance to go face for the world title at SummerSlam, but Seth Rollins able to put him down. Wait a minute. Speaking of the WWE Champion, here comes Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins making his way at ringside, looking to watch this matchup very up close and personal. Looking to have his eye on John Cena. Looking to have his eye on his challenger at Survivor Series here tonight. Well, Cena's got a lot on his plate now. He has to pay attention to Seth Rollins and The Miz. Mostly The Miz, because The Miz could get an upset victory here tonight as well. Matchup is underway. Cut over time. Miz has Cena back against the corner. I mean, what a way for Cena to go at it in his hometown. Miz with that cheap shot. Cut over time once again. What a way for Cena to begin SmackDown Live. I mean, he has to go up against The Miz, and Miz has a chance to get a win while the WWE Champion might provide a distraction, and then a cheap shot by Miz on the Cena, might provide a distraction for The Miz against Cena. As Cena with the strikes off the ropes goes Miz, ducks it to Cena, and over there goes Cena, and now Miz got caught with a hip toss by Cena. And that goes for a cover, hooks the outside leg on the Intercontinental Champion, but Miz able to kick out at one. I mean, until the draft night, John Cena, Seth Rollins never really had any matches before. Hurricanrana, surprise move by Cena. Hurricanrana, two count and a kick out. Miz almost got caught by the Hurricanrana, but Miz with force just taking down Cena at the moment. Now Cena with a roll up. Schoolboy, roll up pin. Got him. No. Miz able to kick out, and now Miz. What a cover. A jackknife cover and the kick out. They try to get that kick. Cena, look at this. Roll up on Miz. No, wait, Miz with a counter of his own. Roll up of his own. Got Cena here now. The kick at it too. Holy. Counter, roll up by both men. And a Miz planting Cena with that swinging neckbreaker known as the Wizard of Oz. The Miz always trying to drive the knee into the back of John Cena. Cena's trying to make sure that Seth Rollins will not be a factor. Oh, tossing Miz. No, Miz tossing Cena, I should say. And a Miz just taunting in front of Cena. And look at John. Oh, God. What the? Oh, no. A suplex to the outside. Good grief. Cena suplexing Miz onto the outside. And now, oh, God. Cena looking to make Miz pay for taunting Cena earlier on in this matchup. It's Cena. Shot taking Miz over the barricade. Reminiscing to Booker T and Seth Rollins having that false count anywhere match, I believe last week on SmackDown Live. And oh, Cena and Miz going at it, but this time there's countouts in this match. Murphy on a count of five, but Cena and Miz going at it. As Cena taking it to Miz in front of the SmackDown Live audience here in Boston. Looking to bring it up close and personal for the crowd. Does Cena. Murphy on a count of seven. Miz back in the ring as Cena. Count of eight. And now, Cena playing mind games. Miz trying to get his head in the right track here. Miz, able to catch Cena. Cena was taunting Miz. And Miz caught up with that big boot. But now John looking to battle back. Great action to begin SmackDown Live here in Massachusetts, in Boston. Up the road, Cena from West Newbury is whipped by Miz and counter. Wait a minute. Seth Rollins got the leg of Cena. Now Miz from behind with a cheap shot. Cena got distracted. Rollins provided the distraction that may cost Cena the match. And now Miz looking to capitalize off of the work of Seth Rollins. And now Miz, oh no! Miz got caught. Miz through the elbow. And now Cena, look at John, racing up the stage. And now look at this! Hurricanrana on the Seth Rollins. Able to catch Seth up on by the stage, by the ramp here. And now Miz is going to follow up. And oh, Cena with a shoulder tackle. My God. Chaos all over the place. And now Cena fighting both men. Building about his suplex on Miz, on Seth Rollins. And now Miz, got caught with a clothesline. And Cena trying to go after Seth Rollins. Already made his way. Oh, God. Again, Miz with force taking down Cena. And now Miz whipping Cena. Referee had a count of six. Seth Rollins able to make his way back into the backstage area. Cena not looking to follow Seth Rollins. Knowing that he has Seth Rollins at Survivor Series. Less than 3 weeks from tonight in Madison Square Garden. The world's most famous arena. Cena with a sit-out powerbomb. Referee way out of position, but powerbomb, cover, and a kick out. A great way to begin SmackDown. We have a lot of action. They have a tag team match coming up next here on SmackDown Live. The Usos taking on Breezango in a number one contenders match. Winner faces the Hardys for the tag team titles at Survivor Series. As The Miz able to counter the Attitude Adjuster and handle that side rushing leg sweep as well. Now Miz, looking to set up for either the figure four or the Skarkers finale. Cena blocked it either way. And now Cena with a taunt, but Miz with a neckbreaker. Neckbreaker by Miz. But Cena battling back. John Cena almost had a disadvantage with Seth Rollins being at ringside, but now Cena, as the fans call it, the five moves of doom coming back into play. Oh! John Cena. Looking to have things his way in this match. Five knuckle shuffle coming. Cena, you can't see me off the ropes. Five knuckle shuffle on the Intercontinental Champion. And now John Cena. Now Cena going up top. We saw The Miz go up top earlier. High risk, no reward. Missed the elbow drop. Now Cena up top. But now Cena going for here too with a crossbody. A crossbody by Cena. And now John setting up Miz in trouble. And it to the Jester. Onto the Intercontinental Champion. Is that a message sent to Seth Rollins? Will that be Seth Rollins at Survivor Series? John Cena wins tonight. John Cena, Attitude Adjuster for the win. Look at his Hurricanrana earlier on in the matchup. Surprising the hell out of the crowd. Hurricanrana almost had Miz a late kick out by two. And then here with the roll up and a counter frenzy by both Miz and Cena. Miz able to counter and kick out of the schoolboy attempt with a jackknife cover of his own. And then Cena with a roll up later on. And then after that, a power bomb by John. And in the end, the Attitude Adjuster for the victory. If Cena does that at Survivor Series and pins Seth Rollins to the mat for the three count, just like in his song, John Cena said, if he lays Seth Rollins down for the 3 second 10, we might be looking at a new WWE champion in John Cena. Cena will win in his hometown in Boston. Look at the celebrate here tonight in front of his fans and friends and family. As far as The Miz goes, he has Ty Dillinger to worry about at Survivor Series. John Cena with a big win here tonight on SmackDown. And they're back here on SmackDown Live, getting ready for this number one contenders tag team title match. Getting ready for this number one contenders tag title match as Breezango taking on the Usos. Winning team faces the Hardys at Survivor Series. Here we go. Matchup is on the way. Saw Tyler Breeze made his entrance and Breezango taking on the Usos. Fandango with that Northern Lights suplex early on in the match. And Jimmy Uso with that elbow. And now look at this. Monkey flip. As Jimmy Uso now, look at this, with a shoulder claw, and oh god, that's a leg sweep by Fandango, and Jimmy Uso battling back. These two have been going at it for the past couple of weeks. We saw them compete at Unforgiven where Breezango able to beat the Usos, so this is kind of a rubber match, so to speak, and wow. Nice neckbreaker by Jimmy Uso, who's now the illegal man. Elbow drop by Jay for good measure. Trying to go for a kick, but Dongo able to get out the way. Now Dongo got him up. Oh! Electric chair taking down Jay. Now Dongo looking to make the tag to Tyler Breeze. Good grief, get him a name drawing. Gotta bear with me, I am sick today. As Tyler Breeze whipping Jay off the ropes. Got caught, reverted DD. No, wait, got countered into a vertical suplex by Tyler Breeze. I really, really am sick today. Holy. Gotta bear with me, guys. I have a cold today, as look at this. I'm trying to duck it, but Tyler Breeze caught him with that clothesline. I still have on my mind about Ty Dillinger taking on Seth Rollins later on tonight. Also, Ty Dillinger competing against The Miz for the IC title at Survivor Series. Make the tag, does Tyler Breeze to Dongo. The question is, will it be Tyler Breeze and Fandango facing the Hardys at Survivor Series? Look at Tyler Breeze going to town on Jay. As Dongo now, oh, what a suplex. Look at this, Dongo on the apron. Oh, a slingshot, a leg drop. Slingshot leg drop by Dongo. A nice maneuver there, but look at this. Jey Uso popping back up with an uppercut. So both teams have a win over the other. I think Breezango's win was more emphatic, so to speak. It was a more of a bigger win than the Usos' win because they won on pay-per-view. They won on Unforgiven a couple weeks back. But tonight will be the ultimate win for either team. One fall to the finish. We'll be able to go to Survivor Series against the Hardys, who defeated the club back in Unforgiven in a tag team steel cage match. Nice move there by Breezango with a double hip toss on Jey Uso and a kick out. Jey Uso able to stay alive. Tyler Breeze not able to get the job done and get the three count. Now you saw earlier Dango taking down Jimmy Uso off the apron, looking to prevent a tag being made by the Uso. So nice Samoa drop there by Jey. And now, oh God, what a super kick! It's the one thing that Breezango gotta watch out for. The super kick. It can come out of nowhere. And we all know Tyler Breeze has his supermodel kick. But still effective nonetheless. Jey Uso knocking down Breeze. And oh! Breeze with that high knee, that knee lift. That goes for a cover. Four in the face. Got Jey Uso down for the cover and the kick out. As Jimmy Uso wants to get the tag in so bad. Able to not let his brother suffer more pain. Nice kick to the gut. And oh, nice clothesline to the outside. Wait a minute. Jey Uso looking to fly onto Tyler Breeze. Good grief. Looking to take the extra mile, so to speak, and just dive onto Tyler Breeze. That's how much the number contender spot means to the Usos. Looking like suplex by Breeze. And now Breeze are going to battle back, choking the life out of Jey. The crowd is chanting, is cheering for, I believe they're doing the Fandango dance, so to speak. You get a crowd singing the Fandango theme song. If you're on a count of five, I believe. Count of six. It's Jey Uso. Tyler Breeze just going at it at ringside and able to make it back inside the ring. And oh, wait a minute. Jey Uso not looking to win a match off a count out. Going up top. Might not be a wise move, and it wasn't. Elbow dropping. Breeze got out the way. Tyler Breeze able to scout Jey Uso, get out the way, dodging that nasty elbow drop that would have done a lot of damage to the spine of Tyler Breeze. And now Breeze just whipping Jey onto the barricade, I should say. And now, oh, high knee. And now trying to go for a forearm, blocked by, oh, the Enziguri head kick. Exchanging shots, both men at ringside. Referee had a high count, I believe at a count of seven. Count of eight, I believe. Count of nine. A high critical situation almost made the 10 count. Barely made the count. And now Breeze trying to go for a shot. Had Uso set up for Uso able to counter. And now, look at this. Made the tag. And Jey Uso with that splash. With that scoop slam and a splash done by Jimmy. Scoop slam by Jey. Splash by Jimmy. And Fandango made the save. My God, what a tag team match here on SmackDown Live. This is the only place you're going to see matches like these. Here on SmackDown as Tyler Breeze, after that high knee, trying to go for a neck breaker. Uso able to counter that. Michinoku driver. Tyler Breeze has suffered a lot of damage. Had to suffer a flying Uso. And then a splash. Also a super kick. And now he's busted open as well. And another super kick by Jimmy this time. Another super kick. And now Jimmy Uso looking to work on Fandango. Tyler Breeze even more. Dango really wants to make the tag. As Jimmy now, moved to the face by Breeze. And now Dango in the ring. We can have some words. I know, able to save Breeze there, but I don't know. As, look at this. Jey Uso looks to be out of it in this match. Kick to the gut. And now, Jimmy Uso with a diving headbutt. Good grief. And now, look at this. Oh. Jimmy looking to fly again from the top. And a splash again onto Tyler. Hooks the leg. Can Dongo make the save? No, he doesn't. The Usos are number one contenders. Fandango didn't make it. Or I don't know what just happened. Jimmy Uso hit the splash. But as we look back on the replay, the super kick earlier in the matchup. And then we see the dive onto the outside by Jay. And then right here, the splash by Jimmy. Jay Uso didn't even get to the ring. By the count of two, Dongo made it inside the ring, but he just stood there and didn't make the three count. He didn't save Tyler Breeze. Well, either way, the Usos are number one contenders for the tag team titles at Survivor Series as they look in the ring and Tyler Breeze got cleaned up. Is he like Dongo? What the hell? Wait a minute! What? Fandango stomping away on Breeze! What the hell is that for? And I'm just going to town on Breeze for what? What the hell does this even mean? As they're back here on SmackDown, you see Fandango backstage. Oh, wait a minute. Sami Zayn confronting Fandango after attacking Tyler Breeze for what? I have no idea. If he's upset about the tag match, he's the one that let the Usos won that match. I don't know, but as we're back here in the arena, here in TD Garden for SmackDown in Boston. As you have this women's action, Brie Bella, they're going to take on Summer Rae. Here we go. Matchup is underway as Brie Bella, right off the bat, side Russian leg sweep, takes down Summer Rae. As Brie, having a SmackDown this women's matchup. Mick Foley told me earlier tonight that he wanted to do what Raw does. Raw would have two women's matches a night. SmackDown would have had one. Looking to upstage Raw or possibly be equal when it comes to the women. As Summer Rae driving the knee to the back. And also later on tonight, we'll see Becky Lynch take on the women's champion. As Becky Lynch is building momentum with these wins. Can she get a win against Dana Brooke? Because if she does get a win, then she'll get a title shot. She will get a title shot down the line. The question is, we don't know when, if she does win against Dana Brooke in any capacity. And now look at this. Oh, good grief. What a Stone Cold-like stunner there by Brie Bella. And now Brie on the second rope. Look at a dive on the Summer Rae, perhaps. As Brie with a drop kick. Beautiful missile drop kick from the second rope by Brie. As Brie Bella with a knee to the back. You've seen a lot of Brie as of late, but we have not seen her sister, Nikki Bella, in quite some time. As kicks there by Brie. Oh, God. Kick to the side of the head. Shaved of her husband and Daniel Bryan. And Summer Rae with that counter. That arm drag. But Brie. Wait a minute. Brie with the lapel lock. The yes lock locked in by Brie on the Summer Rae. Will Summer Rae tap out here? Will Brie get the win off the yes lock in this matchup? Summer Rae able to get out of it. Summer Rae able to battle out and able to fight her way out of the yes lock. Not looking to tap out in this matchup. And now Summer, got caught. Nice takedown by Brie, but shot there by Summer. Good grief. Summer Rae just smashing the head onto the canvas of Brie Bella. Summer Rae, former women's champion. Brie Bella, also a former women's champion here at Universe Mode. Summer Rae hasn't been champion since last year when she was Divas champion. As, wait a minute, look at Brie. Oh, a kick to the side of the head again. And oh, wait a minute. Nice counter done by Summer. And oh, nasty elbow. And now Summer Rae, Irish whip over the top, hanging on for dear life. And now, hip tossing Brie Bella back inside the ring. Goes for a cover form in the face and a shoulder up. Brie Bella right off the one count, able to get a shoulder up. Brie Bella hasn't been champion since last year, when she lost the championship, I believe, to Paige. I mean, Brie Bella, former champion. Oh, wait a minute! Bella Buster! Bella Buster! Out of nowhere on the Summer Rae, and Brie Bella gets the win on SmackDown. Brie Bella able to get a big win over Summer Rae, who's had a couple of big wins herself within the past couple of months. But Brie Bella, that Bella Buster out of nowhere, able to get the win. Three count. Brie Bella successful here on SmackDown Live. And Brie Bella looking to celebrate here in Boston, Mass, in front of 15,000 fans. Now you see Tyler Breeze backstage. I don't know what's going through the mind. Wait a minute. There's Booker T giving Tyler Breeze a heads up. I mean, Tyler Breeze don't know what's going through his mind after receiving what he got from Fandango earlier tonight. Don't know why Fandango did what he did. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it has been announced that at Survivor Series, Kevin Owens and AJ Styles will have separate teams, and they'll go at it. Team AJ takes on Team KO at Survivor Series. It will be a big win, because that stipulation where a winning team will get a title shot will happen. Also, tonight, AJ Styles will take on Kevin Owens. One-on-one action next. As we're back here on SmackDown Live, as we're getting ready for this one-on-one action between the Phenomenal One and the Prize Fighter. Two former Intercontinental Champions looking to battle here tonight. At Survivor Series, you'll be Team AJ Styles taking on Team Kevin Owens. AJ Styles will have to get two more participants for his team, so does Kevin Owens. And that stipulation that has been going on for the past 2 years will continue this year. And what that stipulation is? Well, the winning team of Survivor Series, for those that don't know, the winning team of Survivor Series will compete either the next night on Raw or on SmackDown in a triple threat match. Right? A triple threat match where the winner of that match will receive a WWE Championship match at the next pay-per-view, which is Night of Champions, another dual-branded pay-per-view in the month of December. So AJ Styles has to get two more participants, and so does Kevin Owens. And the winning team will compete in a triple threat on the following show. And then the winner of that triple threat will be number one contender for the WWE Championship. A great opportunity. We've seen the likes of Baron Corbin did that last year, where Baron Corbin won at Survivor Series. He won the triple threat and then was able to go on to compete at Tribute to the Troops last year against Brock Lesnar for the World Heavyweight Championship. 2 years ago, we saw the Rated R Superstar Edge compete against former WWE Superstar CM Punk for the World Heavyweight title in a TLC match at TLC. So this year, this stipulation comes to light again. But tonight, on SmackDown, these two will battle it out one more time in singles action. AJ Styles, Kevin Owens. Matchup is on the way from a kettle of a tie-up to a waistlock. Kevin Owens able to get a waistlock of his own onto AJ Styles. And now KO with a side headlock grounded side headlock onto AJ. What a cheap shot as well. And now look at this. Kevin Owens got AJ Styles up with the torture rack neckbreaker. Big move right out the gate of this matchup. Oh, and a kick for good measure. The last time these two competed on SmackDown Live in a one-on-one match, AJ Styles defeated Kevin Owens with his own move, the pop-up powerbomb. As, oh, over the top by AJ. And now, Kevin Owens in trouble. Oh, God, a back suplex onto this, onto the hardest part of the ring, the apron. Good grief. And now, ooh, AJ Styles and KO are getting battled out outside of the ring at ringside. Saw Kevin Owens' head smashed against the post. If you had a count of three here on SmackDown Live. And now, wait a minute. Oh! Kick to the gut. No, block. And AJ Styles on a clothesline. Still will not forget the classic matchup back at Money in the Bank for the Intercontinental title, where Kevin Owens became a four-time Intercontinental champion. If we had a count of five, I believe. And so I'm pretty sure one of these men would like to get an upper hand over the other here tonight. It's still to come later on our main event. Seth Rollins taking on Ty Dillinger. Also, Becky Lynch will take on Dana Brooke as Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens with the sharpshooter locked in on AJ Styles, but Styles able to find a way out. And now KO looking to whip Styles. Oh, I thought he was going to whip into the corner, but Styles able to catch onto the ropes instead. Nice move. And now AJ with that fireman's carry. Oh, jawbreaker counted by eight by Kevin Owens. And now look at a sunset flip powerbomb. It still amazes me the agility of Kevin Owens at his size and a springboard elbow to the spine of AJ Styles. And now AJ, ooh, attacking the arm of KO. Nice snap suplex by Styles as well. Snap suplex by Styles, cover. And Kevin Owens able to kick out, I believe. If not, or referee caught off of a rope break, perhaps. I don't know. Something along those lines. As AJ Styles. And stopping on the arm. And now Styles on the apron. Oh, look at a springboard 450 splash. Oh my god, a big move by AJ on the Kevin Owens. But KO back up to his feet after that kick to the knee. Ducks it. And oh, Styles caught with a clothesline. Starts with a clothesline, takes down Kevin Owens, and a kick out. I gotta tell you guys, I really like it when I see these two compete inside that squirt circle back suplex. It's always magic between these two, to be honest. And now Kevin Owens, these two have been targeting each other's arms in this matchup, which is something odd because I don't think either man has a arm submission hold. As Kevin Owens kicked in the gut, got Styles in the corner, and oh, Styles suffers the KO cannonball. As you had the crowd chanting, kill Owens, kill earlier in the match. And now Kevin Owens pop up. Oh my god! Pay dividends! Payback! Oh! Payback is hell by Kevin Owens. Styles clashed, and now almost had him there with a. Anyway, able to kick out of two. That's AJ Styles. Almost had him with the Styles clash by KO. Kevin Owens trying to get payback. Like I said earlier, AJ Styles defeated Kevin Owens with his own finishing move, the pop-up powerbomb, not too long ago. And now, Kevin Owens trying to do the same thing, trying to get payback onto AJ. And now AJ Styles, and oh no! Not able to connect, but able to get it back up to his feet. not able to connect the 450 splash, but Styles back up to his feet already. Now both men back up to a vertical base, and now Styles got him. Underhook, oh god. Oh my god, a brain buster. Underhook style by AJ Styles. And now Styles ducks it, Bayley kick to the back of the skull of Kevin Owens. And now Styles, elbow to the knee of KO, but Kevin Owens battling back. Who knows the record between these two going at it? One-on-one matches covered by Kevin Owens off the back body drop and a kick out. Gotta go for a kick, but Styles got out the way that time. And I won't be surprised if AJ Styles tried to go for the pop-up powerbomb himself after what KO tried to do with the Styles clash earlier in this matchup. AJ Styles countering Kevin Owens. And now Styles now on the second rope. Oh my god, a tornado hangman, I guess. A tornado hotshot. Able to land on the apron and then Kevin Owens neck first onto the top rope. And now Styles on the apron. Styles, phenomenal, no! KO got out the way. Trying to go to phenomenal forearm, but Kevin Owens got out the way. Kick to the abdomen. He's going for a ride. Pop-up powerbomb. Kevin Owens. Pop-up powerbomb for the win. Kevin Owens. He tried using the Styles Clash earlier, but not able to get the job done. But able to get the win with his own move, the pop-up powerbomb. So the cannonball earlier right there. The Styles Clash. He tried to get the three count right here. One, two, but Styles and a late kick out, able to stay alive in this matchup. And in the end, right here, pop-up powerbomb for the win. If that happens to all three members of Team AJ at Survivor Series, well, Team KO will compete at Triple Threat, and then the winner of that match will be number one contender for the WWE title. Kevin Owens, able to get the win. And the best thing about this Survivor Series situation is that he can get from both Raw and SmackDown superstars. Alicia Dolby coming up next. It's time for some women's action as the new women's champion Dana Brooke will be taking on Becky Lynch. Can Becky Lynch dethrone the champ? Next. As they're getting set for our second to last match of the night, Becky Lynch, one-on-one with the champ. I'm pretty sure in Becky Lynch's mind that she would love to have the women's title on the line, but we all know that Dana Brooke is obligated to defend the SmackDown Live Women's Championship against Paige at Survivor Series. So Survivor Series is going to be a big show for both Raw and SmackDown brands. The WWE title will be on the line. The Intercontinental title will be on the line as far as SmackDown goes. As we found out the Usos will be taking on the Hardys earlier tonight. We'll find out who will be champions by the end of that match at Survivor Series. And Paige will be chasing after Dana Brooke again as a challenger for the SmackDown Live Women's title at Survivor Series. As far as Raw goes, we have the Universal Championship up for grabs. We have Nakamura taking on Big Show for the United States title. And we have the Raw Tag Team Championships, the Revival, taking on the Lucha Dragons once again at Survivor Series. Dana Brooke look to go to Survivor Series, be the first ever SmackDown Women's Champion to defend the women's title at Survivor Series. As we all know, the women's title was created back, I believe, after WrestleMania. Or the night of WrestleMania, when Becky Lynch won that Fatal 4-Way. That Fatal 4-Way ladder match for the Women's Championship. And the Raw Women's title was created, I believe the night of Extreme Rules, Raw's pay-per-view, back in April. But here we go. Becky Lynch, Dana Brooke. Matchup is underway as The incredible time into a waistlock by Becky Lynch onto the champion. And the slammer gut first, got it with a side headlock. Grounded side headlock and all. A nice shot for good measure as well by Lynch. Lynch, a fan favorite here in the Bean Town, known as Boston. And they'll try to go for a chop block, but no avail. But still effective with their shots in Dana Brooke. And Becky Lynch, count after counter. And oh my god! Springboard kick knocking the champion to the outside. My god, that kick was very vicious by Becky Lynch. Dropping on her arm and now doing more damage, wrenching the arm as well. Look at that. If you had a count of three, and high knee by Brooke. As Becky Lynch would love to get a win over the champion. And, oh, shot to the gut. I'm pretty sure in Mick Foley's mind, she's very up close of in talks with a championship match down the line in her career on SmackDown. If you had a count of six, both women by the announce table area. As, oh god, what a clothesline by Brooke. Dana Brooke with that clothesline, taking out Lynch, and oh god, tossing her onto the steel steps. Count of seven, and oh, again whipping her onto the steps. Wait, count of nine, I think. I thought it was count of seven, but count of nine. Lynch in the ring, but Brooke not able to get back inside the ring. Dana Brooke making a big mistake. As you see here, Dana Brooke whipped Becky Lynch into the ring first before she got back in the ring. So Becky Lynch able to make the 10 count. Becky Lynch gets the win regardless of how it was done. Becky Lynch with the win over Dana Brooke. But ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, our main event, the WWE Champion. They're going to take on Ty Dillinger. Our main event, it is live and it's next. See right here, the champion getting warmed up. Matchup is next. Can Ty Dillinger get vengeance for what happened a couple weeks back on SmackDown? Can Ty Dillinger beat Seth Rollins, or will history repeat itself? As they're back here on SmackDown Live, we see Ty Dillinger in the ring, getting ready for his big main event match against Seth Rollins. Will history repeat itself? Will Seth Rollins beat Ty Dillinger again? Or will Ty Dillinger pull off an upset win over the WWE Champion? Well, we saw the champion earlier tonight giving The Miz the assist, distracting John Cena, but Cena able to stand tall over The Miz. As Seth Rollins looking to burn down Boston, Mass, the TD Garden here tonight. Seth Rollins has been through a hell of a ride as WWE Champion, or at least be in the title picture. You know, since coming over to SmackDown with the WWE Championship, Seth Rollins has been champion the majority of this year so far. From April all the way till now, Seth Rollins has been in that position, battling the likes of Sami Zayn, Daniel Bryan, Fatal 4-Way, TLC matches, taking on Dean Ambrose from countless months, able to end it at Unforgiven inside Hell in the Cell. And now moving on to Survivor Series, the same pay-per-view that Seth Rollins won his first WWE Championship against Chris Jericho in the first season of Universe Mode. And ever since then, Seth Rollins' aspirations for the WWE title has went awry as Ty Dillinger off the bat with the desk press under Seth Rollins as his matchup is underway, our main event. This main event is going as Ty Dillinger whipping Rollins hard. I was whipping to the corner. I mean, after Batista beat Rollins for the WWE title 24 hours later. Seth Rollins, as far as going after the championship, has been a bumpy road. Rollins with that Seth Walker planting Ty and on the apron. They're going to go for the high knee, perhaps springboard high knee to the face of Ty Dillinger. Nice kick there by Seth. These two have been in the ring before. Ty Dillinger almost had a win over Seth Rollins. But Seth Rollins is going through four weeks of Gauntlet heading into SummerSlam. Ty Dillinger in the third week almost had Seth Rollins, but sadly, Seth Rollins was able to get the win over Ty Dillinger that night. Maybe Ty Dillinger had not forgotten, or maybe he is, maybe tonight he's looking forward to correct his mistakes he made on that SmackDown event. As Ty Dillinger looking to have things in control in his way as twisting and turning the arm of Seth Rollins. As Dillinger had something in mind, but maybe Seth Rollins is not in the right position. As, wait a minute, Rollins. I'm gonna scout Ty Dillinger. Seth Rollins! Oh, no, no. I thought Rollins got caught after taunting Ty Dillinger there, but got caught, thus Ty, with the hip toss by Seth. And now Rollins with the Falcon Arrow. Looking to assert his dominance in this matchup. Looking to show the world why he is the four-time WWE Champion. As Rollins up top with a Frog Splash. Frog Splash onto the perfect 10. As Dillinger, with a deep arm drag, taking down the champion. As shot to the ribs there by Seth. As, oh, ducks it, but Ty caught him on a clothesline. As Ty Dillinger also got to keep it in mind that he has the Intercontinental Champion waiting for him at Survivor Series as well. Both men in big championship matches at Survivor Series. Miz against Ty and Seth against Cena. Nice neckbreaker by Ty Dillinger. And now Ty Dillinger, they're going to go up top. Rollins connected with that Frog Splash earlier. Can Ty connect him with whatever he's going to go for? As Ty, they're going to wait for Seth to get up to his feet. Seth Rollins in trouble. Ty with a drop kick. Right on the button. Ty Dillinger with that stomp. And now working on the neck of the champion as well. Maybe tonight could be Ty Dillinger's night. Not only send a message to The Miz, but also beat the WWE Champion. We saw The Miz fall fate to John Cena's attitude adjuster. Maybe Seth Rollins might fall fate to the perfect 10. The knee breaker. Cover by Ty Dillinger. Does he have Seth Rollins? No, he does not. Shoulder up by Seth. Seth Rollins able to get the left shoulder up. Stay alive in this match. As Ty Dillinger might have things his way. Might have the champion reeling here. As Seth Rollins is having a front headlock and a high knee. A knee lift to the chest, I believe, of Ty. And no, trying to go for a clothesline. The back of Ty, but Ty able to duck that. But counter. After counter this match. Fireman's carried by Seth. And belly to belly attempt, but got counter again. But a judo hip toss by Ty Dillinger. And, oh, wait a minute. Ty Dillinger in the corner. Seth Rollins is in trouble. Dillinger got the knee down. Got the knee pad down. The tiebreaker. The tiebreaker on the WWE Champion. Will that be it for Ty? No. And a shoulder up again by Seth Rollins. I thought Ty Dillinger possibly had the champion there with the tiebreaker. But Seth Rollins having a kick out and a senton for good measure by Ty. The perfect 10, they're going to stay on the architect as the WWE Champion up to his feet. This is our main event here on SmackDown Live. Oh my god, I think he caught him there with that Phoenix Splash and set back up to his feet. I think he barely got him, but still effective. This is our main event here on SmackDown Live in Boston, Massachusetts, in front of 15,000 crazed fans here in Beantown. Less than 2 weeks from Survivor Series in MSG. As Seth Rollins looking to put the exclamation point in this matchup for Ty Dillinger with the buckle bomb. Good grief. As Seth Rollins, oh no, 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 no. Seth Rollins trying to go for something, but Ty caught him with the arm. And now whipping Seth Rollins into the corner, does Ty. And oh, elbow to the face. Oh god, the high knee to the face by Seth Rollins Will that be seen at Survivor Series? Seth Rollins gets the win with the high knee. Oh my god, what a matchup. What a main event here on SmackDown Live. Look at this tiebreaker. Ty Dillinger with the perfect 10 knee breaker. Almost had Seth there. And here's the tiebreaker on the Seth. I thought he had him, but Seth Rollins able to kick out with the left shoulder. And then right here, boom! High knee to the face. If that happens to Cena at Survivor Series, plus the 3 count, if Seth Rollins hits the high knee and lays Cena down for the 3 second 10, Seth Rollins will still remain as WWE Champion. Good night, everybody, from Boston, Mass. Stay tuned in to Raw this Monday and SmackDown next week. Good night from Boston.